Hello, I'm Florent Boston. I am a freelance concept and background artist in video games and animation industries. Welcome to this last part of the series, Create a Narrative Environment Painting. I invite you to watch the previous video if you don't, so you won't be lost. Now it's time for the paint over. I start by cutting out the different planes and correcting the values, especially the sky, which is very important because it will set the tone for the scene. Then I break the shape of the 3D by repainting directly over it. I quickly move on to the building in the background, which will not be very detailed. I use a basic brush and paint instinctively using the eyedropper to rework the colors. I leave room for the color accidents created by the grain of the 3D. I will come back to the pictorials later because they are focus elements in my image, so their level of details needs to be adjusted. When I'm painting, I often listen to music, which can be very varied. Sometimes I listen to playlists that make me think of the world I'm painting. It's also a way for me to travel during the creative process. I add buildings at the very back of the city to give depth. They are in the dark, which allows them to contrast with the tower. There are also tubers to see its immensity. I already add some lighting effects to see how it can render, and then I detail the main tower. I zoom in a little bit to be more precise in the details. I often use the lasso tool to have solid shapes and defined edges. I work on the clock from the front before putting it in perspective and giving it volume. I wanted to give a golden, elegant side to the clock with blue to contrast with the colors of the environment. There is little wear or texture in the material. There is a clipping layer for each part, allowing me to paint freely without going over the top. After doing some integration tests on the tower, I continue my design. The goal is not to have a perfectly physically accurate reflection, but to give an impression of brilliance to the material. Now that it is in perspective, I move some elements to create a volume that stands out. I add gold to other places to harmonize the design, and I add a structure to the roof. A few adjustments for the color of the roof so that the blue stands out more. I also try to cool the shadows to have a color contrast. Here are some clouds from a photo that I modified for integration. I curve them to create a line of force. Some bas relief to dress the wall a little and create interest. I do not hesitate to duplicate and modify to same time. I go over the small towers so that their style matches the main tower. Same here, I duplicate and go over it, changing a few elements. A few perspective adjustments on the front face. When I work on a personal project like this, I enjoy myself. I know that there are mistakes and that everything is not perfect, but what is important to me is to enjoy the creative process. I think that's something that comes across in the final result. I keep studio work and my passion separate. In the end, it's almost relaxing to paint for yourself, like meditation. I rework the foreground to add depth and immersion without breaking my composition. It remains dark enough to contrast with the other shots and not disturb readability. I also change the orientation of some bells to give rhythm. And here is the end of this series. I hope you liked it. I invite you to watch the other tutorials on the NVIDIA channel and to follow me on social media if you like my work. See you soon.